Y'all understand what we are to do, brother?
Still got any questions?
God ain't evil. Why God hate a certain race?
How much y'all blessed? Hey, man, we out here for our people, man. We are the battle axes of the Most High.
Won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axes, y'all's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axes, y'all's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for.
Like, you can say what you want to say, but I see for myself. And that's what we got to do, because this truth ain't for everybody. Contrary to popular belief, everybody's not making it to the kingdom.
That's
so
right.
You better make sure you get on that good foot, and you be that one of the numbers called. You understand? Sometimes the Most High say, guess what? You go out to lead your brother. Sometimes the Most High gonna say, you go out to lead your mom. Sometimes the Most High gonna say, you go out to lead your whole family, because they ain't about making it to the kingdom.
That's right.
These brothers out here, we about making it to the king.
That's right.
Every tooth, man. You know what I'm saying? Ask the Most High God if we lying. And we're going to go to some scripture to prove it to you. But give me Malachi 2 and 7. We're going to go there.
There you go. Bring it out.
This is the book of Malachi, chapter 2 and verse 7.
Like I said, I already brought it out, but I'm going to bring it out again, because this is crucial. You being a teacher of the Bible, if we are here standing for the Most High God, we have to speak the truth, man. We can't be up here lying, giving y'all false lies and history and doctrines, man.
That's right.
Leading y'all to the stage, to another decayed state. Our people are already in a decayed state as it is. We're going to push you into the pit. Now we're going to try to get you to that kingdom, to one of the 12 gates. Read it.
For the priest lives shall keep knowledge.
For the priest lives, these pastors, these so-called speakers of the word, they should keep knowledge, man. Knowledge. Go ahead.
And they should seek the law at his mouth.
And that knowledge is the law of the Bible, which these pastors never tell you. You ain't never seen a pastor go to the book of Deuteronomy, where a lot of our laws is Leviticus, the Torah. They won't go to that. They'll show up, jump to Paul, Romans, Galatians, because they don't understand the old. Therefore, you won't understand the new. You got to get built up in the Old Testament in order to receive the New Testament. You understand?
Right.
You can't start a book in the middle of the book and think you got the whole understanding of the book.
That's right.
You can't do that. You can't jump. You can't be a level 1 and jump straight to level 10, thinking you go past the level, right? You can't do that. So read that again.
For the priest lives shall keep knowledge.
Uh-huh.
And they should seek the law.
They should seek the law.
At his mouth.
So when we speak, we got to give y'all laws, man. Statutes and commandments. I got one for you too, bro.
For he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts.
Because we are the messengers. Like I always tell people, okay, you believe in God, right? How do you believe in God? Can we give God a hug and a kiss and show him affection? No, the way you show God affection and show him that you love him and believe in him is by his word. This is all we got to stand on right now. And like I've been teaching all day, faith and the ability to understand the scriptures, that's all we got. But that's a whole lot, brother.
That's
because
right.
We have seen the change in our lives. We have seen that when we go according to the Bible and not according to man, that our lives change into a complete 180, man.
That's right.
Going downhill when I was listening to the pastor. Going uphill when I was turned around and got with the Most High God and started reading the scriptures. Give me this 2 Corinthians 5 and 20.
This is the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 5 and verse 20.
Check it out.
Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ.
And this is why we got to speak the truth. Because like I said, the Most High he's always sent prophets to go out and teach the people. He always, since Moses, since all of the old prophets, he always sent prophets to go out and teach. 2 Corinthians 5 and 20 said, we are ambassadors. Y'all know what an ambassador is? He's like a representative. Say, America sent an ambassador to go over to China and represent and speak for America. The Most High sent the prophets out here to speak to the children of Israel, man. And build them back to the law, statutes, and commandments. So this is very important what we're doing out here. This ain't for play. This ain't no game, man.
But you know what? They put it in the media. They put this little sneaky subconscious. You know what I'm saying? These little, they doing the little interracial thing now. All the movies.
Every commercial you see gonna be interracial.
You got the interracial shit.
Right.
So if we gonna change, we gotta do we gotta play it like them too? Put the little stuff.
Just go back to it again. Go to Acts 5 and 29.
You know those subconscious things, so people can start thinking just like.
No, them. We just gotta know it. We gotta see it. He gave us the spirit of discernment. That's right. Like we out here now, prophesying the destruction of this kingdom. Every great nation is failed, including this nation.
Yeah.
Because it's only great because we're working in it.
That's right.
That's the only reason this nation's great. We out there working hard in the cotton fields. We out there working hard in these warehouses. While the so-called white man got his foot kicked up.
Right.
Don't know Acts 5 and 29. Don't know what he's doing. He can't come out here and do this work we're doing, but he can show and kick his feet up and try to get some order.
That's what I'm trying to say, man.
We out here doing the work. The only reason this country is great and this nation is great because we in.
Every great nation.
Guess what? We was in captivity.
That's right.
Every great nation, man. We was the ones in captivity because that's what made it great. Having the children of Israel work their butts off, going through their captivity to make this land great.
That's right.
They want to say, make America great again. America was great when it was our land, man. When we were doing the things we were supposed to do.
And it's going to be great again.
It won't be great again until we go back into our homeland. And then we're going to rule over this thing.
That's right. Finish this off.
I got you.
As though God did beseech you by us.
By us. Read on.
We pray for in Christ stand, we be ye reconciled to God.
See, that's what we are here. He gave us the ability to give the people the words to get us back together, man. We got to get the Northern Kingdom back as well as our people. It's a tough job out here, man. You got all our Northern Kingdom, it's a call in this idolatry. Doing every other thing against God. You got our people believing that our Lord and Savior is a so-called white man that you're supposed to love everybody when they shooting us down the streets. Is that love?
Yeah.
That's what they got us doing. They did a number on us, man. They did a great number on our people, and we have to get up out of that situation with our minds, reconcile our minds back to the Most High God.
Do y'all think what Bob Jean's
Brother did when he hugged.
That was terrible, man. That was terrible. Because the Bible don't tell you to love your enemy, man. That's your enemy, right, man.
And then they gave
See, we don't understand. We don't understand that when the Bible say love your neighbor, that's the people that's going through it with you. What the hell I got to go through? What I got to love somebody in Plano for? They don't do dirt about me.
Right.
I don't go to Plano. I ain't in Plano. Those so-called white folk out there kicking and living it up. 12 o'clock in the day. It's packed. Why? Because they ain't working. They chilling. Edomite alert, that's right, Edomite alert. Tell them to stay, hey, tell them to get 4 feet away from you. We don't want to kick it with the dogs, and we tell them to their face, you going into captivity. That's the words of the Bible, and that's what we prophesy and teach, man. That these so-called white folk are going into captivity, what they did to us, what their forefathers did to us. And we got to pay for our forefathers. They got to pay for what theirs did.
That's right.
Push the so-called black. You better push them. Because you know the Most High just might show you a little favor, might give you 18 hours in that cockfield instead of 21.
That's right.
And you're still going into slavery. Ha-ha. Joke's on you.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 3 and verse 31.
Bring it out.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
What did the Bible tell us to do?
Envy thou not the oppressor.
You got our young kid children out here. Gold blonde strips in their hair, women whole head blonde. Why you trying to be like your oppressor? Why you trying to look like that dog, man? That ain't the greatest thing. The Most High God made us the greatest thing.
Deuteronomy 7:6
said we was the greatest people on the nation, above all people. So why you want to bring your status down to a lower state and be like the so-called white man, man? All praises, man. Hey, we hope you got this thing, bro. Hey, don't get me. Hey, brother, don't get me. Get the Most High God. You know what I'm saying? Do this for the Most High God, man. Do this for your salvation, man. Read that again.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
So envy not the oppressor, man. Don't try to be like these so-called white folk. They want to do Halloween. We're doing it in the church. They want to do Christmas. They want to do an Easter egg hunt. Easter ain't got nothing to do with our Lord and Savior. What a bunny got to do with our Lord and Savior. Envy thou not the oppressor. Don't do those things that they do.
And choose none of his ways.
Now, I'm going to do some of them. I ain't going to do Halloween, but I'm going to dance. I'm going to for sure do Christmas.
And choose none of his ways.
Well, I ain't going to blood my whole hair, but I'm going to put two blood strips in my beard.
and choose none of his ways.
The Bible's gonna give you the answers, man. It say choose none of their ways, man. Because every way they had has been negative, man. Every way they had has been abominable, man.
That's right.
They the ones out here being the wicked. They got our people out here being homosexual faggots.
Right.
Oh yeah, we're gonna make laws now. You can be a faggot. You can marry a dog. We don't do that kind of mess, man. But guess what? You're gonna find some of our people. Oh, I married a dog yesterday. Great Dane. He's a Great Dane. He's a great name. Great Dane. That ain't our custom. We don't do that, man.
Yeah.
They want to do what we do, man.
Yeah.
They want to be cool. Like the brother said, you ain't never seen a gangster white boy. No. No, they want to be.
That's
but
right.
They don't got to go through the mud like we do, man.
That's right.
They don't wake up and hope they don't get fired every day from their job because they can't go to work that day.
That's right.
But they knew if they call in, they going to get fired.
Yeah.
They ain't got to worry about that because guess what? Dad has an oil rig.
Yeah.
All I got to do is go ask Dad for a job. Matter of fact, Dad going to give me $20,000.
Right. He's going to give me a loan.
He going to give me, it ain't no loan. He going to give it to him again. Oh, Tommy, this is the last $20,000. I mean it, Tommy. I'm telling you, this is the last $20,000. Until Tommy gonna get locked up in jail again for overdose on an opioid and get out of jail again. Well, just give me 15, man. Tommy, this is the last 15, Tommy. You know what I'm saying? For real, bro, we know this, man. The Most High give us the spirit of discernment, man, to discern the world of what's going on right now, man. And our people are lost in the South.
That's right.
That's right.
If you ever want to talk about the South, you lost in the South.
That's right.
You doing everything for the world. You want to drive a Beamer, Benz, a Bentley, instead of going out there reaching your people. You in the Bentley, but your people walking.
That's right.
Your people in the Chevrolet. And I ain't talking about the truck. I'm talking about they shoving one foot and laying the next.
That's right.
They walking, but you out here living three-car garage. What is that, man? We need to start worrying about the condition of our people, man.
Woo.
This ain't no individual thing no more, brother.
Right.
This is a nation thing. We
That's
got going,
right.
Man.
That's
we are here to talk to the nation. That's why this week out there going hard loud. Because we want everybody to hear this, man.
That's right.
If we have one bigger, we go get it.
That's right.
Let downtown hear the whole thing. Everybody, hey, what are you guys talking about? We talking about y'all wicked bus, Esau.
Yeah.
That's what we talking about. What you got for me? We're bringing out. We can go there too.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 10 and verse 1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel.
Oh, who?
O house of Israel.
Now, this book for everybody.
O house of Israel.
You want to know why history was shitty, and I forgive me for my language, but history wasn't worth a nothing to me, man. And I was a pretty smart brother, man. I ain't gonna lie. I got all my grades done. But I just couldn't get down with history, man. I don't want to hear about all these white navigations that ain't did nothing for nobody. That's because our history book is right here.
That's right.
That's their history book, a bunch of lies. They want to pull up Christopher Columbus. The hell with Christopher Columbus. They want to talk about that myth. This is our history book right here.
But
to speak to the children of Israel, man.
Their history.
Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen.
Christmas.
Learn not the way of the heathen.
Halloween.
Learn not the way of the heathen.
Easter.
Learn not the way of the heathen.
And we can just go on and on with this thing. Learn not the way of the heathen, bro.
Thanksgiving,
chapter 14. Thanksgiving, bro. All these things, man. Thanksgiving. That's when they slaughtered our Native American people, man.
Yeah,
gave them chicken pot on their blankets, man. Smallpox. All this stuff, man.
Yeah.
That is wicked. But we supposed to love them people?
Right.
No, sir. You and Jeremiah 6 and 16. Read this.
This is the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, verse 14.
Because, brother, what we got to do is we got to remember, man. We got to get back to remembrance. And the only way you remember is by going into our history book and looking and seeing what our remembrance is, man. You got to remember what happened to our people, our ancestors back in the day. Learn from the wrong and try to keep the right that they did. You understand? Shoo away what was wrong and try to keep what they did right. Remember, we got to remember. This is what else we got to remember.
If my people,
the Most High got us out of Egypt, he said, let my people go, right? That was a certain group of people. That's them so-called black Latinos and Native Americans. And the Bible said, if my people, you Israelites, you so-called Israelites who don't want to be Israelites, you blacks, Native Americans, and
Native Americans and Hispanics.
If my people, which are called by my name,
The most, the game that the Most High God gave us. See, the brother said, "Well, yeah, we gotta pray to the Most High God, but you gotta pray as an Israelite, brother." That's the name that you get of tribe of Judah, tribe of Issachar, tribe of Gad, tribe of Reuben. We gotta pray as an Israelite, brother. He said to remember the name that he gave us, man.
Shall humble themselves.
You gotta be humble, man. You gotta put off what you was taught. Your pastor taught you that lie for 18 years and then it resonated as the truth. But natural, it's the lie. And that's what we out here to break down, these are lies. So you gotta humble yourself, bro.
And pray.
And what?
And pray.
That's the biggest thing, man. You gotta pray for the destruction of all these wicked nations. You gotta pray that the Most High come and get us out of the condition that we're in. You gotta pray that the Most High take those bad thoughts and evil communication that you had out of your mouth and head and give you a new man, man. Put you on a new man. We gotta pray, man.
And seek my face.
And seek the face of the Most High God. How do you think we can seek his face? Through the word, doing the commandments, brother.
That's right.
You want to seek his face, you're going to get stronger and stronger in these scriptures by keeping the law.
That's right.
Psalms 111:10 all day, man. You're going to get stronger and stronger by keeping the commandments, man. Trying to seek the Most High God's face. Look, you got $4 working right there. I bet they went, hey, brother, you got some kibbles and bits? Hey, brother, I don't need no weed or nothing. I just need some kibbles and bits, man. Hey, you got any? Okay, never mind. For real, we can read up. Turn from your wicked ways, like I told you. You got to do a 180, man. You got to stop going down and start going up, man. You got to get right. Turn from your wicked ways. Turn from doing all this pagan stuff we were doing. Turn from doing all this wicked stuff we were doing, man. Because you know we all got some wicked ways, man. Yeah. And I'm talking about all of us. Yeah. Everybody think that, oh, y'all out here thinking y'all holy or not, brother, please. Right. You called me 2-3 years ago, I've been in them streets, man.
Yeah.
And you called me with, and not with a mic in my hand, but something else, man.
Yeah, right.
So come on, man, we got to turn from our ways, and that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to set examples for our people, man.
Right.
We're trying to be the spokesman, the ambassadors for the Most High God, man.
That's right.
That's what we are. He gave us that job.
Then will I hear from heaven.
Hold on, say that again, that first word that you just read.
Then will.
Nah, I don't want no other word but that.
Then.
What?
Then.
What?
Then
you gotta do something. That's crucial. He say then, and only then will I hear from heaven. Man.
That's right.
You gotta show Lord some actions, man. You gotta put that work in, like you said. Faith without works is dead. Oh, I love him. I know him. Holler to him about you don't know nothing.
Right.
How about you put some fringes on, throw that beard out, sister, wear that hair wrap, put on that dress. Then you can show us something. He said then, and only then will I hear from heaven, man. Because he was throwing the prayers out, man. Look at this right here, man. I get tired every time, boy. Tippy town, you're running, but every time I get up here, you got a brother want to walk his dog, man. You got a leash for him? What is it? What is his name? Becky? Is that Becky too? See, they don't like that. They don't like when we call this out, man. But the Most High told us to call this out because you're not supposed to be with that white woman, man. She don't believe that the Most High God sent his son, Yahweh Shah, a black man. Yeah, get away from you, damn right. I'm going to walk 10 steps in front of you, honey.
The book of Sirach, chapter 27, and verse 20.
Bring it out.
Follow after him no more.
Do what?
Follow after him no more. I'm
going to get in front of you 10 feet. I can't do it anymore.
For he is too far off.
For what?
For he is too far off.
Brothers is bugged out. They gone, man. All the way gone, man. You won't walk his dog, man. No, you ain't got no leash 10 feet, man.
He is as a roe escaped out of a snare.
A roe escaped, man.
For as for a wound, it may be bound up. And after reviling, there may be reconciliation. But he that bereft secrets is without hope. He that winketh with his eyes worketh evil.
Worketh evil. That's all he doing, man. He ain't doing nothing but making a cause for destruction.
Because
sooner or later, that's going to be destroying that relationship. Oh, you keep talking about this black God, black Jesus. Who is that? Yeah, that's the truth of the Bible. But guess what? They don't want to hear it. They don't want to go.
They don't want to go.
And he that knoweth him will depart from him.
And he that knoweth him will depart. So shit even make him stop doing this thing.
That's
you need to start reading that Bible. Go get you a New King James. Go get you an NIV. That's a little nicer. It doesn't say that in there like that one. Get you a new Bible. Then he gonna stop forgetting it. He'll, oh, you know what? I love you so much, honey. Forget the Bible. Forget the Bible. I love you enough just to say you forget the Bible.
When thou art present, he will speak sweetly.
Oh yeah, like he delivered, but he got away from her. But when they was out there walking by ten, before you could see him, oh, he was all hugged up with her. Yeah, yeah, boo, you know, later on when I get home, when I get you off this train, you know what I'm saying, it's gonna be me and you, girl. But then when he get right here, he go 10 miles before I get away. Get thou tempest thee.
And will admire thy words, but at the last, he will wrench his mouth and slander thy sayings.
Wrench his mouth, like I said, shit had that brother forgetting God, forgetting his God, not keeping the commandments anymore. That's what they do, Deuteronomy 7:3.
I have hated many things.
What?
I have hated many things.
Hated many things, man. That's one of the most I got hate right there. He hates that thing, man. Why would we be a Deuteronomy 7:6, a holy person, the most greatest person, then go to the dog, man? He hate that. I made you to be special, and you gonna go and give your blessing away. Give the best thing you got away, which is you being a child of God, Israelite.
But nothing like him.
But nothing. So there ain't nothing like us, man. That's what he's trying to tell him, man.
For the Lord will hate him.
The Lord will do what?
For the Lord will hate him.
No, the Lord don't hate God. The Lord can't hate. The Lord hate a lot of abominable things, man. Yeah, right, and we can go there too.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 3. Neither shall thou make marriages with them.
The Bible ain't gonna miss a beat, man. Ooh. Neither shall you make marriages with these so-called Edomite white women, these Edomites. You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, stop going to these Chinese women thinking, oh yeah, I want to see what that look like. I want to see how that did. Now, the Most High gave you 12 nations to deal with. You deal with them nations. Brother, we're jamming. Now we got the law, the commandments in his mind. He jamming, rolling around.
My daughter, thou shalt not give unto his son.
So if I had a daughter, you got a daughter, a so-called Edomite want to come up and marry our daughter, get your backhand. Right. I do a whole Iker team on this thing.
Okay.
Right. Get your what? Say, you want to do what? Say, you want to do what? You want to do what?
You won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're going to be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, y'all's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're going to be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, y'all's weapons.
14 verse 2, uh-huh. Joy of mourning and the gates thereof language.
He said the real Jews are in mourning. And the gates, they ain't got no gates right now. We ain't got no protection.
They are black.
They are what?
They are black.
Now the so-called white man wrote this Bible.
They are black.
If the so-called white man wrote this Bible and steps on it, they would have took out that the real Jews are black.